2015, he donated. We were privileged to receive a lorry load of publications from him, copies of publications from him, and the copies of Making of a Nation and some used equipment and so much more, which we were very glad to receive. Hilary Boniface Ngweno's immense contribution to the introduction of in-depth, independent, and incisive journalism in Kenya has not been celebrated without some criticism of being a sellout at some point in his career. Critics argue that Hilary Ngweno, one of Kenya's most celebrated principal journalists of all generations, turned into a literary villain and a sellout at the sunset of his career when he allegedly fell prey to President Moi's arm-twisting antics to silence the Fiery Weekly Review into toning down on its attack on the Nyayo regime. The Weekly Review allegedly started enjoying indirect state funding through government advertisements. As a result, Hilary Ngweno was labeled a Moi apologist and the Weekly Review branded in its final days as any other rag in the media market. But those in defense of Hilary argue the Weekly Review never attacked the Moi regime since the inception of the magazine. They say the Weekly Review professionally analyzed facts and published them without fear or favor. Well, I ask you all, what is your take on this?
Thank you. Thank you, Felicity.